Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Amaka of Skyvel Beauty, and if this is your first time here, you're most welcome. If you're a returning subscriber, you're the real MVP. So today's video, I'm going to be reviewing a foundation and showing you my foundation routine as well, because I found that I don't quite have an in-depth foundation routine video on this channel. So let's jump straight into the video. So the foundation I'm going to be reviewing today is the Maybelline Fit Me Matte and Poreless Foundation, guys. This foundation is an OG, it's not a new foundation, but I finally tried the Maybelline Fit Me foundation, and I must say that I am blown away. Sometimes when we see products being highly raved about and being praised, it's not just a hype, everybody cannot be lying. The products sometimes are usually very, very good, and I found that this Maybelline knocked it out of the park. I am in the shade 340 Cappuccino. I know we've seen this all over the internet and all of that. I got this whilst I was in Accra, and it was 70 Ghana cedis, which should be around 5,000 something. You can get this in Jumia stores across Nigeria as well as on Jumia.com. It doesn't come with a pump, as we all know, so we would have to pour this on the back of my palm. I've tried this out, and I must say it has a beautiful yellow undertone. This is what we want to see in our foundation, not red, yellow. Some of us are yellow, okay? I like to use brushes, especially for my foundation. I find that this is quicker and it just saves me time, like, to be honest. And I use the Beauty UK primer. This is their Prime FX primer. I'm just going to take that on my brush, just dab a little bit, and then dab it onto the skin, the area where I want, and I'm just buffing it into the skin. I find that this is the best way to apply this foundation. I don't go like that, I just buff it into the skin, and it dries down matte, guys. Can you see how perfect this matches my skin tone? Like, can you see? This is how you want your foundation to look like on you when you apply it. I'm a matte girl. I don't like anything greasy, anything luminous, glow. No. I will glow with my highlighter. When it comes to foundation, please let it be matte. Lipstick, matte. Concealer, matte. Powder, matte. Everything matte. And I find that with this, because of how perfectly it matches my skin tone, I don't need to go all the way down to my neck. Like, can you tell the difference between my face and my neck? If your foundation matches you right, you may not need to go down your neck. Guys, can you see the finish of this foundation? Like, do you see how flawless and matte and beautiful it looks? It's not a drying matte where your skin feels tight, but it's a true matte, because I've seen foundations. I was using the ColourPop No Filter foundation, and it claimed to be matte, but honestly, it wasn't matte. Like, it's not a matte foundation. I don't know why they are selling it as matte, but this is what a matte foundation looks like. There's no sheen, there's no greasiness, it's just beautiful and flawless, and it dries down almost like powdery, almost as if I've applied a little bit of powder. Flawless blend. Oh my goodness. You see, this is the side without any foundation, and this is the side with foundation. The difference is not much. This is how foundation should look. Beautiful. It just evens out our skin tone, makes the face look flawless. So let's try on this side. I take little by little, and then I blend. I don't pack on the product, because if you do that, even with a foundation that is your actual color, you're going to look cakey, and it's not going to look flawless. So I go little by little, take a little bit on the back of my palm, spread it nicely on my face, and then I blend. This literally blends like a dream. I don't struggle. I don't have any issues whatsoever. Like, it just blends away. And that's it. There we have it. My foundation is all done and the face is looking flawless, beautiful. Like, guys, just take a look at this. It dries down matte like a powder. It looks like I've powdered my face already, but I haven't. So if you apply this foundation, quick tip, don't go in with your concealer and all that. Give it a few seconds, maybe like 5 to 10 seconds, for it to set. It will dry down matte and it will look gorgeous. Wow. And guys, I still have a little bit left on the back of my hand, which we would nicely scoop back into our jar. A lot of people were complaining that, oh, they want a pump, they want a pump, they like a pump, they need a pump, a pump, a pump. I like this without a pump. You know why? Because I don't waste products. When you have a product like this, this is a ColourPop no filter concealer, and you pump, what I find is usually the squirts that come out, you can't control it. So it's either two squirts is too small. If you pump twice, it's either you get too little product, and if you try to pump extra, you get excess product, and it's so messy. But with this one, I will just open the top, pour as much as I want, apply it. When I'm done and I have excess left over, I scoop it back in and life goes on. So please, Maybelline, if you're watching, do not put a pump to this foundation. Just leave it like this. We love it like this. It's literally like, it feels dry. So for concealer, I usually go in with my ColourPop no filter concealer. I am in the shade dark 32, and this is a very yellow based concealer, which is what we like. It's lighter than my skin tone, so it brightens up the under eye area, and I really like it. I take that much under my eye and then I just lay it flat and draw down. I like the paddle applicator that comes with the ColourPop concealer. It helps with spreading the product quickly, and it also helps me with the bridge of the nose application. So I'll apply the highlighter on my cupid's bow like so. Apply a little bit on my chin. I don't like to spread it all the way here, because when you blend, it's going to spread anyway. So I like to just keep it right here. And then I like to draw a tree right here. It's not really for the fancy or the fun of it, it's to help with placements. That's why I do it like that, so that when you're blending, you know where you're blending. So it's not really because we like to draw on our faces. Another new technique that I started doing is to blend my concealer using a dry beauty blender. I used to do this back in the day, and then I stopped. I started wetting my beauty blender, and that is good and fine. But I find that when I use a dry beauty blender, not only does the concealer blend and it helps me with placements, I find that the concealer itself is more concentrated. The product is not going everywhere, it's going exactly where I place it. But if this was wet, it would be spreading and going all over the place. This is a regular Forever 21 beauty blender, so it's not like, oh, it's one expensive beauty blender. You see how much coverage we have with that. It gives me more coverage. That is the word I'm looking for when I use it dry, as compared to when I wet the beauty blender. And it blends really nicely as well. Now the next step in my foundation routine, I usually go in with my setting powder, which is the ColourPop No Filter setting powder. This one is in the shade Banana. It's a really nice soft yellow color. I like the fact that it's not stark white, and at the same time it has that yellow color mixed into it. So some of you may be wondering why I'm using powder when I'm not done with contouring. I find that setting my concealer first before moving on to contour helps with limiting creasing and all of that. So if you leave the concealer on as you're blending your contour, this one will be creasing. So I just like to set it before I go on to apply my contour. But what I'm doing here is I'm pressing into the pot, and then I'm dabbing the excess off on the back of my palm, and then I'm applying it onto my face. Now we're moving on to the Black Opal Stick Foundation. This is what I use to contour my face. I use the shade Carob, and I go in and blend with my foundation brush. I probably should get a separate brush, but I find that with the leftover of the foundation that is on this brush, it helps to diffuse the color of the contour products. And also, I don't apply this straight onto my face anymore. I find that gives too much product. I just dab a little bit from the brush and then I start blending. This way I'm not getting too much product onto my face, because we don't really like a harsh dark contour. Then I'll just go over the perimeters of my face very lightly. Dab a little bit. I pinch the brush and I contour my nose. And I'm taking this all the way up to my eyebrow area. At this point, I'll take my powder brush and my Zaron loose powder. I use the shade LZ20, and I'm going to wipe off the excess setting powder we have on our face. I find that with this particular ColourPop powder, you don't want to leave it for too long because it's really pigmented, and if you bake for too long, it's going to leave a white cast. So we set the rest of the face and then sweep off the excess. And now for the ultimate airbrush effect, I like to go over my entire face with a big powder brush like this. It's really big and fluffy. Just going to go over the whole face. This helps with any harsh lines and all of that. And voila, there we have it. Our face is completely done. This is how I do my base. This is how I do my foundation routine. This is the step that I follow, okay? So I'm going to go off camera, complete the rest of my face, and then I'll be right back. All right, guys, so here is the completed look. I really hope you guys enjoyed the video. I enjoyed filming it as always. My final thoughts on the Maybelline Fit Me Foundation. I highly, highly recommend that you buy this. If you have never tried it before, this is a matte and poreless one. I know they have a luminous one. I don't know, but this is the matte and poreless, and I think it's absolutely amazing. It's not very expensive. I mean, it's 5,000 something, and you get how many fluid ounce? One fluid ounce standard, standard amount, and it's really good. Like, look at how flawless my skin looks after foundation. I think it's so gorgeous. It matches me nicely, and I really, really like how this foundation wears. I'm not doing a wear test because I have already worn this foundation a couple of times, and I know how well it applies. Like, it really, 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 really works really well. It applies beautifully. It's easy to blend, and it lasts all day.
Okay, I find that I don't have too much oil seeping through when I use this. It keeps me matte for the most part of the day. And it's just a beautiful foundation. Overall, I am highly impressed. Maybelline never fails. Like, they really put out really great products. I think I've only had one Maybelline product that I used that I ended up not liking, which is their Great Lash Mascara. Like, all their products are really bomb, and this foundation gets a thumbs up from me. Yeah, so thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye guys.